Hey everybody. So I'm here in Seattle at the IHME at the University of Washington. And today I'm really excited because I'm going to be speaking to Professor Emanuela Gakidou. She's not just a professor, she is the professor of health metrics sciences. And really, it's a discussion that everybody should be focused on. How do we map the populations of the world to make sure that everybody gets services that they so desperately need?
You can't find answers without asking the right questions. This is The Prompt with me, Trevor Noah.
It's really wonderful being here, especially talking to you. You are somebody who's well accomplished, both in your field and outside of it. But I wonder if it's strange to you that you are now known as the person who made it that red wine is no longer healthy for you.
Part of what we're known for is following the evidence and updating our work. So the older you get, red wine can be a little healthy for you, is the new research that we've come up with.
I feel like that's it's a perfect segue into not just what you're doing now, but how you think. You work in a field that is always trying to get to the core of what is and what isn't as it pertains to people's health. Let's talk a little bit about, I guess, something that everyone should be focused on, because it affects how we build the world around us, and it is where people live, how they're living, and what affects them.
Yes, a very important component to measuring health is knowing where people live in the world. So we have to know where people are in order to be able to provide them services, know what might make them sick, know what they might need, know where food needs to be provided, where clean water needs to be provided. And there are a lot of areas of the world where we may know roughly the population of a country, but not exactly how the population is distributed among areas within the country.
You know, I have an idea of AI. Everyone has an idea of AI. Some people think of it as, you know, a prompt that tells them how to write jokes. Other people think of it as, you know, something that can fold proteins. In your world, just in this particular use case, what is the AI doing? Or what is it trying to figure out that would take so much longer for the average human being to do?
So satellite imagery can help us figure out where on the planet there are structures and where there may be more structures now than 5 years ago.
Using those images and then using AI to try and ascertain where people live because of the structures.
Yeah, absolutely. So if there is growth in the structures in a particular geography, it's a reasonable assumption that there's growth in the population. And then we can take the census we have from as recent as it is. And we also know how many children people are having on average. If we have information on cars or cell phone ownership, using AI and a lot of new computational methods, we can process the information all together to tell a cohesive picture.
One of the maps I remember looking at, I think it was in Niger, and you look at the census data that assumes a population, you look at the maps that you're now working with, you realize how many forgotten people there are in many ways, or unknown people who exist in these places. How do we improve the world that people are living in because of this information that we're now getting at a faster rate?
In crisis situations, we can't afford to waste any resources. So if we know how many resources are needed where, then that really helps make the most efficient use of what we have available to us.
I'll probably need AI to understand everything you do, so I'm gonna keep doing that. Thank you for keeping us sane, keeping us healthy, and for trying to make the world a better place.